Nice to have you with us.
To the rest of us.
It's happening.
Oh, Sally, you're going to make me.
Here it is.
Oh, boy. You're all fizz.
I don't know. I don't know if a fizz is really me or
no,
not. That's the dignity of Match Game, isn't it? You look like Art Carney.
Thank you. This hat once belonged to none other than Archie Bunker.
Yes, that was the last hat they made for Archie Bunker and all in the family. And when I finished making the very last show in 1978, I walked off with his hat.
Yep. And she's letting me use it today. And it does sort of make me feel like Art Carney.
Look, he's got the mannerisms now.
Hey, Ralphie boy.
Let me tell you something. Not only did you get that shirt from Riley, I got this tie. Will you stop that?
All right.
Shut up.
why don't we say hello to our contestants today, huh? All right, hello, Jeff.
How are you, Nash?
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
You did very well yesterday, $1,650. And you're in the Strike Force Rescue Team. Is that
we get Strike Rescue.
Strike Rescue.
Yeah.
Where if I happen to crash my plane, you'll come in and get me.
No, probably not.
Well, good luck today on the show.
Thanks, Ross.
All right, Jan, hi. How
hi.
Are you? Now, please tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm Jan Moore. I live in Anaheim. I'm a dog trainer, and I show my dogs in obedience trials.
Well, good luck today on the show.
Thank you.
All right, you know how we play Match Game. The goal is to match as many of our celebrities as you can. Every correct match is going to be worth $50, and the one who scores the most at the end of the game is the winner, keeps the money, and gets to play Super Match, which is shot at $10,000.
Yes.
Well,
yes.
Jeffrey, you get to start the thing off here. Make a selection. Question A or question B?
Let's go with A.
You're going to go with A. Okay, here we go, hat people.
The big A.
Steve the hairstylist. Oh. Moonlights.
He does? Well, what does he moonlight as?
He's got another job.
He moonlights
as a gardener.
Ah. Oh.
After he cuts your lawn, he blanks it.
Hold on.
Oh, Sally.
Art.
Okay.
Yep, he's there, Joe.
Hold on.
Here, Chris. There is so much pressure on this show, isn't there, Chris?
I like kissing.
Okay. Jeff, Steve the hairstylist is moonlighting as a gardener. After he cuts the lawn, he blanks it.
Blow dries it.
He blow dries it. Chris?
He most definitely blow-dries it.
He blow-dries it. Sally?
He mooses it.
Mooses it. imaginary moose?
Unless
she's hot. All right, Charles.
See, it's a hair question, and you know how a man with a hat that has a toupee takes the hat off?
No.
Well, very carefully, but something like this.
Howdy, man.
Sets or style?
Sense of style. Okay, Eileen.
Yes.
Eileen, yes. Steve the hairstylist moonlights as a gardener. Uh-huh. After he cuts your hair, he blanks it.
I like that answer better than this one, but this one's not bad. He curls it.
Uh-huh. All right, Joe.
Well, how about teases it?
He teases it. Daphne, we're looking for a blow dries.
Let's see. How about $100, Jeff?
Hey, blow dries. Yeah. Two matches. All right, we got two matches, Jeff, with $100. Jan, let's see how you do with this question. Gloria said, I love my new husband. But boy, is he dumb. He can't even blank without instructions.
Hold on.
Charles Zanmark.
Quick art.
This was so long ago, I had to
pick. Okay, the celebrities are locked in, Jan. Gloria said, I love my new husband, but boy, is he dumb. He can't even blank without written instructions.
Make love.
Make love. Say, Chris, now that sounded very lovely, didn't
it? Well, being a man who's good with instructions. Let me try that one. Being a man who's good with instructions.
Can't even what without written instructions?
He can't even make love.
He can't even make love. Sorry? Can't even what?
Well, I thought that would be too naughty, so I said, take out the garbage!
Quickly they turn.
Now, I don't know if it's a match. It's close. I don't know what the judges would say.
We have a judge.
Make love.
Yes, that's a match. All right, Eileen. This new husband is dumb. He can't even blank without written instructions.
I think the blank would probably suffice, but we can fill it in.
Make love. We're on a hot streak.
I don't know why I got into this business. When I come up with answers like this,
go to the bathroom. Oh. No match, Daphne. We're looking for making love.
Well, before we even get to making love, he's still reading because he can't even kiss without it.
He can't even kiss. We've got three matches, and we're going to take a break. We'll be back with matchup. We can go up your score. Playing against the clock. End of the first round, Jeff has 100, Jan, you have 150, but now it's time for a matchup. This is where you can build up your score by playing against the clock. Jeff, you happen to be behind, so we'll start with you. You can play with any one of our stars. Who do you want to play with?
Let's go with the man in the fez.
The fez man.
Ooh.
Joe.
Don't tell the wives. We are going to a convention.
Jeff, we're going to show you a series of possible matchups. Use the buttons there on your secret screen to select what you feel is the best answer. And then every time Fez Man Joe agrees with you, you get $50. You get 30 seconds to get as many as you can. You ready? Go. Coffee blank. Coffee shop. Coffee break.
Coffee shop.
Match. London blank. London broil. London bridge.
London broil.
No match. Daddy blank. Daddy Warbucks, Daddy Longlegs.
Daddy Warbucks.
Match. Miami blank. Miami Dolphins, Miami Vice.
Miami Dolphins.
No match. Pig in a blank. Pig in a poke, pig in a blanket.
Pig in a blanket.
Match. Pardon my blank. Pardon my dust, pardon my French.
Pardon my dust.
No match. Look at it. Oh, three matches. Jan, your turn. Play matchup. Who do you want to play with?
Daphne.
Oh. Okay, you remember, $50 per match. Get as many as you can in 30 seconds.
Yes,
ready,
okay,
Daphne?
Yes,
Jan, go. Running blank. Running on empty, running scared.
Running scared.
Match. Who blank? Who done it? Who cares?
Who done it?
Match. My blank. My goodness, my left foot.
My goodness.
No match. In the blank. In the mood, in the pink.
In the pink.
No match. Welcome, blank. Welcome, Matt. Welcome, wagon.
Welcome, Matt.
Match. Saint, blank. Saint Nick. Saint elsewhere.
Saint Nick.
Match. Andrew, blank. Andrew Jack. Oh, didn't get it. To be behind now, 250 to Jan's 350. You get to make a selection. Which one do you want?
Let's go with A again.
Oh, we're gonna go with A. All right, here we go, stars. Pete the promoter said, I'm going to open a combination wrestling arena and delicatessen. My girls won't wrestle in mud, they're going to wrestle in blank.
It's always been my secret desire. Okay, here we go. There's no art necessary
All right.
on this one.
Looks like, oh, everybody's locked in. Jeff, Pete the promoter said, I'm going to open a combination wrestling arena and delicatessen. My girls won't wrestle in mud. They're going to wrestle in blank.
Potato salad.
Potato salad. All right, we'll see if it's there. Potato salad.
Now, you know, Rush, having been in as many delicatessens as I've been in, I gotta tell you something. I forgot. Oh, yeah. Whenever I wrestle, I always do it made of good corned beef.
Wrestling in corned beef.
That's right.
Sally, wrestling in what?
Well, it's the consistency of mud, and it starts with an M like mud, and it's mustard.
Answer, Charles.
We're happy to be sitting next to Miss Escondido of 1990. She just won on the mustard again.
Okay, Eileen.
Okay, Ross.
His girls won't wrestle in mud. They'll wrestle in.
I want to see all those girls in their mustard.
Well, mustard's a popular answer. We got a roll going here with mustard, Joe.
A roll with mustard?
Wow. Yeah.
One chicken soup.
One chicken soup. We're trying desperately to match potato salad, Daphne.
From experience, this should have been your answer, darling.
Mustard. All right, well, score is 250 to 350. We didn't get a match mustard. There this time. So, Jan, here we go with yours.
Okay.
See how well you do? Herbie said, see all these Band-Aids on my face? On Halloween, I went to a party at the aquarium and went bobbing for blanks.
Blanks.
Are you all right, Charles?
Yeah.
Okay, Jan. Herbie said, see all these Band-Aids on my face? On Halloween, I went to a party at the aquarium and went bobbing for blanks.
Piranhas.
Where you going, Rick?
All right, you big hunter, you.
Yes, having braved the docks of Africa, I have faced many a time wicked beasties. But there's never been any beastie quite so wicked as the dreaded piranha.
Piranha! Okay. Sally, have you got the piranha?
Well, yes, I was in Africa too with Nigel. And we were going down the Nile, and we ran across the piranha, and I don't know what it is.
Charles, have you spent much time in the jungle, Charles?
Not really. But I went for alliteration because I learned the word on this show earlier in the week.
Yeah.
So I said barracudas, bobbing for barracudas.
Bobbing for barracudas.
Well.
Sharks. Joe?
Well, there we were, sailing down the Amazon. We had to look out because there were piranhas.
Very good, very good. Daphne, all right, if you got a piranha there, we can match
well,
up.
Well, I taught him alliteration.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, you did. Yes, you
but
did.
But I didn't use it this time. It's piranha.
You used piranha. Okay, we have four matches. You did very well, guys. You have $550. Jeff has $250, and it's time now for final matchup. And whoever wins this round wins the game. and a chance to play for a possible $10,000. So, Jeff, since you're trailing right now, you'll get to go first. Who would you like to play with?
Let's play with Eileen.
Eileen. Good. Okay. This time, every matchup will be worth $100, and we're going to give you 45 seconds this time to get as many as you can. But remember, you have 250. Go as far as you can. You must get at least 550 to stay in the game. Ready?
Yeah.
Go. Blank pad. Bachelor pad, mattress pad.
Bachelor pad.
Match. Blank lane. Memory lane, penny lane.
Memory lane.
Match. Blank front. Cold front, false front.
Cold front.
Match. Blank collector. Coin collector, trash collector.
Trash collector.
No match. Blank train. Runaway train, choo-choo train.
Runaway train.
No match. Blank scout. Boy scout, talent scout.
Boy scout.
Match. Blank crackers. Animal crackers, Ritz crackers.
Animal crackers.
Match. Blank case. Pillowcase, briefcase.
Pillowcase.
No match. Blank press. Bench press, printing press.
Printing press.
No match. Blank wheat. Whole wheat, shredded wheat.
Whole wheat.
Match. Blank grace. Oh, six matches, though.
That was good.
Good job, Jeff. Good job. 850. Okay, the score. Jeff has 850, you have 550. This is your chance to go for the win, Jan. Who do you want to play with?
Sally.
Gonna play with Sally.
Okay.
Sally got a new hat for you. All right, let's have 45 seconds on the clock. Sally's ready with a new hat.
Don't I look like Whistler's mother?
Not even close, Sally. Ready? Okay, you're ready too then, Jan?
Ready.
Go. Blank belt. Fan belt, seat belt.
Seat belt.
No match. Blank service. At your service, military service.
At your service.
No match. Blank nest. Bird's nest, empty nest.
Bird's nest.
Match. Blank grapes. Sour grapes, seedless grapes.
Sour grapes.
Match. Blank duty. Do your duty, tour of duty.
Tour of duty.
No match. Blank taker. Census taker, undertaker.
Undertaker.
No match. Blank slide. Rock slide, slip and slide.
Rock slide.
No match. Blank keeper. Bookkeeper, zookeeper.
Bookkeeper.
No match. Blank belly. Jelly belly, beer belly.
Beer belly.
No match. Blank Ben. Gentle Ben, Big Ben.
Big Ben.
No match. Blank time. Oh, out of time. It has been fun.
Yes.
If I say, pet the dogs for us.
Okay.
Thank you very much for playing Match Game. Bye-bye. Okay, bye. We're going to be right back with our Big Money Super Match with Jeff right after these words. Please stay tuned. This is the time for the Big Money Super Match. This is where you can win over $10,000, Jeff. And to do that, we'll start with an audience match. You ready?
Okay.
All right, we polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Fred Blank. Fred Blank. Now, if you can guess the most popular answer, you get $500. If you guess the second most popular, you'll get $250. If you're the third best answer, you'll get $100. Now, to help you, you can get the aid of three of our celebrities here. Who would you like?
Eileen?
Fred Flintstone.
Fred Flintstone.
Who else?
Joe.
How about Fred Mertz?
Fred Mertz.
Fred Mertz.
That's good, that's good. One more.
Chris?
I don't want to say Freddie DeCordova. I want to say Fred and Ethel. Maybe, can I do that? Would that work?
Be the same as Fred Mercer.
That would be the same as Fred. What?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's a good idea. Thank you. He not only gives me a shirt, he gives me the right answer. Fred Astaire.
Fred Astaire. Okay. All right, so you have Fred Astaire, you have Fred Flintstone, you have Fred Mertz, or you can pick one of your own.
Well, I come from the cartoon generation, so let's go with Fred Flintstone.
Fred Flintstone it is. Okay. All right, let's see how well you've done. What is the $100 answer? Fred Sanford.
Sanford.
No, we didn't think of that. Yeah, all right. How about the $250 answer? Fred Astaire. That was an assist by Charles. All right, let's cross our fingers. Hope you're in the $500 region here. What is the $500 answer? Fred Flintstone. I don't think Fred Astaire would like that too well. But you won $500. That means you'll be playing for at least 10 times that, or $5,000, by matching one of our celebrities head-to-head. You could go for double that, or $10,000 with a lucky spin on our prize, on our star wheel.
Okay.
Let's go.
Let's do it.
All right, stand over there. This is how it works. You give it a big spin. Whichever star it lands on will be your partner in the head-to-head. If it lands on a red dot, you'll be playing for double or $10,000. Give it a great spin. All right, it landed with Sally. She's going to be your partner in the head-to-head. To win the money, you must match her with an exact match. Now, if you're ready, we'll go for it. Please, no help from the audience on this. Danny Blank. Sally, write down your answer for Danny Blank. Danny Blank. All right, she has hers, Jeff. What is your answer to Danny Blank?
Danny DeVito.
All right. Danny DeVito. Sally, for $10,000, what is your answer?
This is why I'm the queen! No!
$12,500. He comes back tomorrow with our champion. That's all for Match Game. I'm going to save for the next time. Department of Nutrition will receive Resintel's Escapade.
Say hello to our stars for being here, huh?
Yeah,
thank you. This is something that came up. One of the audience members came up to me and asked me, does Chris do an impression of his father, Jack?
No, I'm much too tall to do my father.
You're much too tall.
Yes, Joe does a great impression of my father. I do a great impression of Walter Matthau.
That's how much you know. That's not cornflakes. That's linguine.
Wait a minute. What is that, the case of the cat people?
Oh, well, they check out that. Oh, never mind.
And who are you, anyway?
There's a little bit of Alan Alda, I think, in there, too, wasn't there?
Yeah, well, I don't know.
Oh, we don't know. Let's say hi to our contestants here. Hi, Jeff.
Hey,
you've had a fine job here. You've done very well. $500 so far.
You bet.
Returning champion Jeff. And this is our new challenger. Hi, Patty.
Hi.
Now, Patty, would you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes, my name is Patty Healy. I live here in Los Angeles where I work as a bartender.
All right. You know how we play match game.
Hi.
It's easy. The goal is to match as many of our celebrities as you can. Every correct match is worth $50. And the one who scores the most at the end of the game is the winner, gets to keep the money and play Super Match, which is a shot at $10,000. All right, Jeff, big guy, you get to make your selection first. Do you want question A or question B?
Let's go with A.
You're going to go with A. Okay, stars.
Okay.
This one is about Dumb Donald.
Oh, boy.
Dumb Donald is really dumb.
How dumb is he?
Well, he is so dumb that he thinks the TV show Twin Peaks is about blank. Method act your way through this, can't you, Chris? All right, Jeffrey. Dumb Donald is really dumb. He thinks the TV show Twin Peaks is about blank.
Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton. See, the audience happens to agree with you. The audience likes that. Yeah, Chris.
I said that Twin Peaks was about a Playboy bunny.
A Playboy bunny?
Early in the show here.
Sally, Twin Peaks. Imagine yourself being dumb. What would you think Twin Peaks would be?
Stumble out of bed and stumble to the kitchen, pour myself.
Yeah!
Okay.
Oh, what a surprise.
What a surprise. Eileen, he thinks the TV show Twin Peaks is about
a lady who graced the stage not too very long ago.
Dolly Parton. Okay, Joe, can you match Dolly Parton?
You know, Jack Lemmon's not the only Jack I do. I think even Nicholson would say Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton. Very, very well. Now, Daphne, did you say what you thought? Did you think that Dumb Donald thought Twin Peaks was Dolly Parton?
Well, I'm usually pretty dumb, too, but if it was 10 years ago, I thought it was me, but it's Dolly Parton.
It's Dolly Parton. Five matches. Okay, Patty, we're going to see how well you do with this one. Yeah. All right, you all know that Ted Turner is trying to colorize all those black and white movies. Well, he's also a rich man. He just bought the LA Zoo, and now he's going to colorize the blanks. Sally, what are you doing up there?
I'm doing artwork that you're going to love later.
You better.
Okay.
It better be suitable for the Smithsonian. Okay, Patty. You know that Ted Turner's trying to colorize all those black and white movies? He just bought the LA Zoo, and now he's trying to colorize the blanks.
The zebras.
The zebras. He's got that dumb Chris look on his face.
It just, I went for a kind of a poetry kind of thing here. He's trying to colorize the critters.
He was just trying to be vague enough to cover enough of the animals. Sally?
I may be slow, but I'm correct.
You got it. Only the white. See, black and white movies is misleading. Only the white is colored. So I said polar bear. I'm sorry.
Polar bear.
Charles. Yeah, you don't boo him.
All right, at the zoo, he wants to colorize the blanks, Eileen.
The appropriate answer is zebra.
Zebra, oh, sure. Thank you.
Actually, you can just call me Woody. And I would just like to say this about colorization. I don't think that he should go to the zoo and colorize the pandas or the zebras.
Or the zebras. A lot of matches here. Daphne.
There's also penguins, but I didn't write that.
You wrote zebras. You wrote zebras. Four matches. You have 200. Jeff, you have $250. We're going to be back with a matchup where you can build up your score by playing against the clock right after these words. Jeff has 250, and Patty, you have 200. It's time for matchup now. And this is where you can build up your score by playing against the clock. Patty, you're behind right now, so we'll start with you. You can play with any one of our stars. Who would you like to play with?
I'd like to play with Eileen, please.
All right, Patty, look, we're going to show you a series of possible matchups. Use the buttons there on your secret screen, and you select the answer you think is best. Every time Eileen agrees with you, you get $50. You have 30 seconds to get as many as you can. Ready? Go. Fly blank. Fly ball, fly me.
Fly ball.
Right. Stick blank. Stick shift, stick in the mud.
Stick shift.
Match. Beaver blank. Beaver dam, beaver cleaver.
Beaver cleaver.
Match. Bow blank. Bo Peep, Bo Derek.
Bo Derek.
Match. Party blank. Party animal, party pooper.
Party pooper.
No match. Flip blank. Flip Wilson, flip flop.
Flip Wilson.
Match. Jump blank. We got some matches. We got some matches there. Five matches. Your turn to play a matchup. Who would you like to play with, Jeff?
Let's try Joe again.
I'm ready.
Joe Williams is ready. Remember now, you get $50 per match. Get as many as you can in 30 seconds. Both ready?
Yes.
Go. Milton blank. Milton Bradley, Milton Burl.
Milton Burl.
No match.
Too bad.
Head blank. Head start, head and shoulders.
Head start.
Match. Lemon blank. Lemon pledge, lemon meringue.
Lemon meringue.
Match. Tooth blank. Tooth decay, tooth fairy.
Tooth fairy.
Match. White blank. White night, white Christmas.
White night.
Match. Detroit blank. Detroit Lions, Detroit Tigers.
Detroit Tigers.
No match. Blank, meat blank. Meatball, meat market. $450 to $450. We have a tie. We'll be right back for Match Game in just a moment. We have a tie score. Jeff, $450. Patty, $450. Jeff, you're in the champion seat, so you'll get to make a selection. Question A or B?
Let's try B this time.
All right. A shot here. Okay, stars. Yeah. Wild Wilma is really uninhibited.
Oh, hello, uninhibited, is she, Ross?
She even posed nude for her blank photo. Wild Wilma is really uninhibited. She even posed nude for her blank. Okay, everybody, Joe, have you got yours ready?
No.
No?
No, I do.
Now you do. Now let's play. Jeff, Wild Wilma is really uninhibited. She even posed nude for her blank photo.
Her wedding photo.
Oh, I didn't think of that. The wedding photo.
That's
Chris. She posed nude for her blank photo.
It's going to be one of those 3 out of 3 days. I'm batting 1,000 today. I just want you to know. I feel real good about this
wedding
show.
Photo.
No, I didn't say wedding photo. I said something that I thought was much funnier, but it's not. Driver's license.
Driver's license. Yeah, yeah. I think the audience liked that one too. Sally, we're looking for a wedding photo.
I know, but I didn't think anybody would marry Wild Wilma, being the wild woman that she was. So I saw her down at the DMV in
her driver's license.
Just to keep the show varied, I spelt it wrong.
Right. Eileen, she was wild. She posed nude for her blank photo.
Yeah, her driver's license. Then,
I know, that's what I thought. Joe?
Yeah, well, I've been a bus driver for a long time.
Look at this. Look at this. 5 of 5. All right, Danny.
It's a clean sweep.
Another driver's license. Okay. Score is still tied. 450 to 450. Patty, we'll see how you do with this one. Okay. Magician David Copperfield said, President Bush asked me to create a new illusion. He wants me to make blank disappear. Magician David Copperfield said, President Bush asked me to create a new illusion. He wants me to make blank disappear. Charles?
No, I can't wait.
Do you want to change? I'm going to change. Charles, do you want to be mean?
Yeah, no.
I'm changing.
You're changing yours too?
Yeah, that's out of here.
Oh, my.
Well, now wait a minute.
We've had a fit of conscience here at the match game.
Well, how silly.
You better go with the answer. She's going to
All right, everybody's in now. Okay.
Well, we haven't had this much trouble since the Roseanne Barr question.
All right, the conscience hit them. So, Patty, listen to this. Magician David Copperfield said, President Bush asked me to create a new illusion. He wants me to make blank disappear.
Barbara.
Barbara.
Talk about me.
And you were worried? You know something about the marriage? We don't know. All right, let's see.
You know, gosh, Ross, suddenly I sort of feel like an archangel here.
President Bush wants to make blank disappear, Chris.
Well, you know, I thought I was mean and nasty, but Syria doesn't even hold a straw to that.
Syria.
Very serious.
Very serious. Syria. Sally.
Well, I didn't want to name a particular country because then I thought I'd get letters from everyone that lived in that country.
Sure.
So I named an entire region. The Middle East.
Well, you didn't name Barbara.
Well, I didn't want to, you know, list a special country because I got sort of get letters from a lot of special countries, so I listed as a specific country, so I said the Middle East.
You said the Middle East. Eileen, you had your answer almost immediately.
Oh, I know.
Yes, President Bush wants to make blank disappear. What was the blank?
Oh, gee. I don't even know whether I should say what I'm going to not say now. Maybe President, never mind. Dan Quayle.
Whatever would make you pick Dan Quayle, Joe.
Well, as a political analyst,
yes.
Let me just say that the correct answer is Congress, but the funny answer is Dan Quayle.
Look at this. We haven't had a match in two questions so far. Help us out. We're looking for Barbara.
I matched Eileen.
You got Quayle, too. We have no matches.
Zero for zero.
All right, we couldn't get a match. On our questions, and it's time now for final matchup. Whoever wins this round wins the game and a chance to play for a possible $10,000.
Oh,
you're in the champion's chair here, Jeff, so you'll get to go first. Who do you want to play for?
Sally.
Okay,
all right,
Jeff.
Sally. Now, this time, every matchup will be worth $100. We're going to give you 45 seconds this time to get as many as you can. Go as far as you can. You both have $450. You ready?
Ready.
You ready, Sal?
Oh, yes, Ross.
Okay. Go. Blank herring. Red herring, pickled herring.
Red herring.
Match. Blank code. Morse code, zip code.
Morse code.
No match. Blank tube. Inner tube, boob tube.
Inner tube.
Match. Blank bride. Blushing bride, princess bride.
Blushing bride.
No match. Blank hanger. Cliffhanger, clothes hanger.
Cliffhanger.
Match. Blank bowl. Rose bowl, Super Bowl.
Super Bowl.
Match. Blank rehearsal. Dress rehearsal, wedding rehearsal.
Dress rehearsal.
Match. Blank hall. Annie Hall, Arsenio Hall.
Arsenio Hall.
Match. Blank sister. Sob sister, twisted sister.
Twisted sister.
Match. Blank temple. Mormon temple.
All right.
Oh, what a good time. Score is 11:50 with Jeff. Patty, you have 450. This is your chance now to go for the win. Who do you want to play with?
I'd like to play with Charles, please.
Okay, dear. Charles.
Good luck, sweetheart.
All right. Remember, you have 450. He has 1,150. You have to beat 1,150 to win. All right, let's have 45 seconds on the clock. Ready? Go. Blank Robinson. Jackie Robinson, Mrs. Robinson.
Mrs. Robinson.
No match. Blank attack. Sneak attack, Big Mac attack.
Sneak attack.
No match. Blank toy. Boy toy, tinker toy.
Tinker toy.
No match. Blank shock. Sticker shock, future shock.
Future shock.
Match. Blank Marx. Karl Marx, Harpo Marx.
Harpo Marx.
No match. Blank women. Designing women, little women.
Designing women.
Match. Blank Simpson. Bart Simpson, O.J. Simpson.
O.J. Simpson.
Match. Blank gown. Evening gown, cap and gown.
Evening gown.
Match. Blank, Eden. Barbara Eden, East of Eden.
Barbara Eden.
Match. Blank, Barry.
Oh. Oh. That's on. You're the winner.
Thank you so much for playing. Thank you. I had a great time. All right. Thanks very much. We have some nice things for you. We're going to be right back with Jeff and a big money super match in a moment. Please stay tuned. Thank you. Now, Jeff, you've been here before.
Okay.
Jeff knows all about this part of the show. This is the big money super match where you can win over $10,000. You ready?
Okay.
Okay, recently we polled a studio audience and got their best response to this. Happy blank. Happy blank. Now, if you can guess the most popular answer, you get $500. Second most popular answer, $250. The third best answer, $100. Now, to help you, you can enlist the aid of three of our celebrities. Which three would you like to help you?
Joe, I'll go with the easy one. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Charles?
Happy days.
Happy days. Uh-huh. All right. Daphne. And Daphne.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays. Happy holidays. Happy days. Happy birthday. You can use one of those or one of your own.
I think the old standard. Happy birthday.
Yeah. Well, this is a happy birthday. All right. All right, let's take a look. What was the $100 answer? Happy face. Nobody had that one, did we? The $250 answer was? Happy days. See, this is the one you want. The $500 answer, the one we're looking for, is happy birthday. You've been here before. All right, you've won $500. That means you'll be playing for at least 10 times that, or $5,000, by matching one of our celebrities head-to-head. You can double that amount if you get a lucky spin on the star wheel. So why don't we get it in here and see how he does? Take a step up there, if you will, Jeff. Okay, do you check the time? Certainly. Okay. All right, now spin the pointer. Whichever star it lands on, Jeff, will be your partner in the head-to-head. If it lands on a dot, that's double the money, or $10,000. Jeff, give us one of those big, hearty spins you have.
Okay, come on, double. Come on, double.
Your partner, you're going to be playing for $10,000. To win the money, you must match Joe head-to-head. Remember, this time we have to have an exact match.
Good luck.
Please turn and face me if you can, and no help from the audience. We really don't need any distractions on this. Joe, please write down your answer to this. Blank, rabbit. Blank, rabbit. Joe looks like he has his. Jeff, what's your answer for blank rabbit?
This one's tough, but I'm going to go with Roger Rabbit.
Yeah! All right. For $10,000, Joe, can you match Roger Rabbit?
Well, you know, there are a lot of rabbits in the business, Doc. Like Roger Rabbit. Yeah!
$650. You're going to come back tomorrow.
No problem.
All right, folks. We're going to go. We'll see you next time on Match Game.
Departing contestants will receive Relaxo. is Gene Wicks speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson television production. Get ready to match the star. The star of Quick Kids Challenge, Jonathan Brent. From the Golden Girls, Betty White. Match Game Zone, Charles Nelson Reilly. From Mama's Family, Vicki Lawrence. From Out of This World, Joe Lasky. And from Just the Ten of Us, Deborah Harmon. As we play the all-new star-studded Match Game. And here's the star of Match Game, Russ Schaefer.
Thank you very much. Welcome to Match Game. Nice to have all of you here. Hello, stars.
Hello, Ross.
That was very nice. Nice in unison there. Now, Jonathan, you have to tell us the Quiz Kids Challenge.
Right.
What is that? Now, tell us what that is.
It's a new show that'll be on this fall, and it's three kids, age 8 to 13, playing in a game show against three college-educated adults answering really tough questions.
And no contest.
Yeah, no contest. The kids usually
win. The kids win like 65% of the time.
Well, what would be a typical question? Give us
Okay. Geography question. Multiply the number of Great Lakes by the number of states in the Union that touch the Pacific Ocean. What do you get?
You get more lakes? Is that what you said?
20 is wrong. 25 is right. Five Great Lakes, five states touch
five
the Pacific.
Five Great Lakes. I knew that. Oh.
All right. Let's meet our contestants today. Jeff, it's good to see you again. Jeff, you've done well. $23,650, and remind the folks what it is you do for a living.
I'm part-time pilot in the Navy, a reserve pilot flying strike rescue.
Yeah, strike rescue.
Right.
Yeah. Ooh, you're on a rescue mission now. Wendy, hello, how are you?
Hi,
welcome to Match Game. Now, what do you do?
Well, I teach English as a second language.
As a second language, mm-hmm. Which is your first, what is your first?
My first is English and my second is English.
See, I couldn't trip you up, could I? Well, good. See, we this is a game that we do in English, so you should do well at this game. Yeah. All right, let's play Match Game. As you know, the goal here is to match as many of the celebrities as you can. Every correct match is worth $50, and the one who scores the most at the end of the game wins the money, gets to play Super Match, and a shot at $10,000. Jeff, we'll go with you first. You have your choice of A or B.
Let's go with B.
You're going to go with B first. All right, here we go. Stars, Ivan the Inventor said, I just developed an amazing new car. Instead of gasoline, it runs on beer. The only drawback is that every 10 miles, it blanks. I know, this, you have to be careful.
Yep.
Betty has such a concerned look when you're...
There are so many choices.
All right, Joe's in. Okay, everybody's in there, Jeff. Ivan the Inventor has this new car that runs on beer, and the only problem is that every 10 miles, it...
Burps.
It burps. It does, it burps. Okay, Jonathan, let's see how you do with this. The only drawback is every 10 miles, this car...
It burps.
It burps.
I wasn't sure you could say burps on TV, Jeff, so I put burps, and then the British version, belches.
Belches.
Funny, Betty? Belgium.
Burps. Betty, what do you think about this car that runs on beer?
Well, I know when I have to go, I stop. It stops.
It stops. Charles.
I'm working on questions for Jonathan's show. If you multiply all the pizza parlors in Venice by the rivers that run through Chile and Bolivia.
Oh, yes. Okay, Vicki. The only problem with this car is that every 10 miles, it...
Well, I guess the ladies are, you know, with the same thing happens to us. It
tinkles. Oh. Yeah,
thank you, Vicki.
Bail us out, will you? Yeah,
belches.
Yeah, we'll take that. Deborah?
Yeah?
This car?
I'm very happy to say that I can help Jeff out here because my dad was also a pilot in the Navy. I have burps.
Burps. Look at that. Four matches. Jeff, you got 200. All right. Let's see how you do, Wendy. Here's the A question. Dumb Donald is so dumb.
How dumb is he?
Well, I have the answer right here. He thinks that blank is a virgin. Dumb Donald is so dumb, he thinks that blank is a virgin.
Vicky.
Okay, Charles, how are you doing?
Fine.
You've got it?
Yes, I'm the roar.
Okay, and Vicky's in. Everybody's in. Wendy, your turn. Dumb Donald is so dumb, he thinks that blank is a virgin.
Zsa Zsa Gabor.
You're right. That would be dumb. That'd be uninformed. That would... Jonathan?
I thought that Dumb Donald was so dumb that he thought Madonna was a virgin.
He's going to say virgin in the mouth, so yes. Madonna.
Now, this is a match, believe it or not. You could tell when you're getting old.
Yeah.
I spelt it wrong.
Oh, look at that. He's so dumb that he thinks
I
that
blank. I never thought. I said Madonna.
Okay, Joe.
I want you to know that I was brought up in the match game and that I thought Dumb Donald was always really dumb. His mom.
We're looking for Zsa Zsa, Devin.
Well, I'm going back to Mary Tyler Moore days, and I was going to say Betty White.
All right, you have 50. You've got one match. Then Jeff, you have 200. We're going to be back with matchup where they're going to build their score against the clock in a moment. Please stay with us. Okay, welcome back. At the end of the first round, the score is 200 for Jeff, 50 for Wendy, and now it's time for matchup. This is where you can build up your score by playing against the clock. And Wendy, since you're trailing right now, we'll start with you. Okay. You can play with any one of our stars. Who would you like to play with?
I'd like to play with Betty, please. I'd
like to play with Betty, then. All right. Now, we're going to show you a series of possible matchups.
Okay.
And use the button on your secret screen there to select what you feel is the best answer. And then every time that Betty matches you, you'll get
$50.
You get 30 seconds on the clock. Get as many as you can. Betty, are you ready?
I'm always ready.
You're always ready.
See, I told you my answer.
And Wendy? All right, let's go. Hamburger blank. Hamburger bun. Hamburger helper.
Hamburger bun. I'm sorry.
Match. Security blank. Security guard. Security blanket.
Security blanket.
Match. True blank. True love. True blue.
True love.
Match. Comic blank. Comic relief. Comic strip.
Comic strip.
Match. Sesame blank. Sesame seed. Sesame street.
Sesame street.
No match. Fort blank. Fort Lauderdale. Fort Knox. Oh, we're out of time.
Betty!
Oh, we got... Four matches. That's very good, Wendy. Very good. Okay, Jeff. It's your turn to play matchup. Who would you like to play with?
I think I'll play with Joe.
Hi, Joe. Jeff, how you doing?
Joe Lasky. All right, $50. Remember this every time you get a match. $50.
Okay.
We'll put 30 seconds on the clock. Get as many as you can. You ready, Joe?
Ready.
Okay, Jeff. Go. Pearl blank. Pearl Bailey. Pearl Harbor.
Pearl Bailey.
Match. Spare blank. Spare change, spare tire.
Spare change.
No match. Jumbo blank. Jumbo shrimp, jumbo jet.
Jumbo jet.
Match. Orange blank. Orange crush, orange juice.
Orange crush.
Match. Drag blank. Drag race, drag net.
Drag net.
No match. Kitty blank. Kitty cat, kitty litter.
Kitty cat.
No match. J blank. Oh.
Uh-oh.
Oh. All right, three matches. Score is 350 to 250, and we're going to take a little break. Come back with more Match Game right after these words. Welcome back. Well, Jeff, you've got 350. Wendy, right now you're behind, so we're going to start with you. Make a selection, question A or B.
B, please.
Oh, B. Okay. Here we go, stars. Bob the Bachelor.
Bob the Bachelor said, I think Sally is a little too anxious to get married. On our very first date, she brought along a blank. Bob the Bachelor said, I think Sally is a little too anxious to get married. On our very first date, she brought along a...
marriage license.
A marriage license. They were just thinking of something else. Don't worry. All right, we're looking for marriage license. Jonathan, on that very first date, she was too anxious to get married. She brought along...
I was going to put marriage license, I promise. And then I thought maybe judge, and then I thought a minister.
See, that might have been that was a pretty good one, Betty.
Back in my day, it would have been a nightie, but now that's such old hat, I veil.
A veil?
You were always told to wear a veil when you went out, weren't you?
I still am.
A preacher.
I'm still looking for marriage license, but Sally's too anxious to get married. Vicky, on her first date, she brought along a...
It crossed my mind, that pesky license. I said she brought a shotgun.
Okay, Joe.
Well, Brother Ross, I'm afraid she brought along a preacher.
A preacher. All right, still no match. Can you please match marriage license,
Well, I can't, but they're going to like my answer because I copied off of Vicky.
Oh, shotgun. Yeah, okay, you like that. Any matches? No matches, but we do have another question here for you, Jeff. Donald Trump said...
Uh-oh.
What did Donald Trump say?
See, you're dying to know, aren't you?
Yeah.
All right. Life is no fun when you're broke.
No.
I used to live in a penthouse, but these days I live in a blank house. I live in a blank house.
In a blank house.
And Vicky's in. Okay, Jeff. Donald Trump said life is no fun when you're broke. I used to live in a penthouse, but these days I live in a...
Outhouse.
Oh. Okay, Jonathan.
Well, I was thinking of Ivana, so I was going to say doghouse, but I said outhouse. Yeah.
What do you think of Donald Trump if he were poor?
Well, if he were poor...
Where would he live? In a...
I don't think I'd even think about him. I'm just catching on to this game, and I'm trying as hard as I can, but they boo at the drop of a hat. Out.
Yeah! Yes, Charles.
Not in, they say, a because.
Outhouse. Okay.
See, I thought outhouse. Now, don't yell at me, because everybody's taking pot shots at him. I said a glass house.
A glass house.
Too clever.
They liked you a minute ago, Joe.
I know.
Joe, is an outhouse in the offing here? Doghouse. Okay, Deborah, can you match outhouse here?
No, well, the poor Donald has to live in the doghouse.
In the doghouse.
Sorry.
Jeff, you're doing a very nice job. You're 500 you have, but Wendy, you have 250. It is time now for us to play final matchup. This is final matchup. Whoever wins this round wins the game. And a chance to play for a possible $10,000. Now, Wendy, you're trailing at this point, so you go first. Who do you want to play with?
I'd like to play with Jonathan, please.
Okay, Jonathan
Prince. Thank you, Wendy.
All right, now this time, a matchup is going to be worth $100 instead of $50, and we're going to put 45 seconds on the clock instead of 30. All right, get as many as you can in 45 seconds. Remember, you have $250. Go as far as you can, but you must get at least $500 to stay in the game. Okay. All right, let's get 45 seconds on the clock. Jonathan, you're ready?
Sure.
Uh-huh. And Wendy?
I thought you wanted me to put 45 on the clock.
No. Go. Blank ring. Wedding ring, boxing ring.
Wedding ring.
Match. Blank file. Rank and file, nail file.
Nail file.
No match. Blank roll. French roll, drum roll.
Drum roll.
Match. Blank puck. Wolfgang puck, hockey puck.
Hockey puck.
No match. Blank scotch. Butterscotch, hopscotch.
Hopscotch.
Match. Blank museum. Wax museum, art museum.
Wax museum.
Match. Blank strings. Guitar strings, heart strings.
Guitar strings.
Match. Blank driver. Backseat driver, cab driver.
Backseat driver.
No match. Blank degree. Master's degree, third degree.
Master's degree.
Match. Blank pin. Safety pin. Wendy, 850, Jeff with 500. Jeff, this is your chance to go for the win. Who do you want to play with?
Let's play with Deborah.
Okay, Jeff.
Okay, Deborah Harmon. All right, you have 500. Remember this, you have got to beat 850 to win. Let's put 45 seconds on the clock. Deborah, you ready?
Ready.
Jeff is too. Go. Blank yard. Barnyard, backyard.
Backyard.
No match. Blank well. Get well, wishing well.
Wishing well.
No match. Blank hop. Hippity hop, bell hop.
Bell hop.
No match. Blank diamond. Hope diamond, baseball diamond.
Baseball diamond.
Match. Blank car. Foreign car, armored car.
Armored car.
No match. Blank account. Bank account, charge account.
Bank account.
Match. Blank helper. Mother's helper, hamburger helper.
Mother's helper.
Match. Blank lamp. Table lamp, Aladdin's lamp.
Table lamp.
No match. Blank pocket. Air pocket, pickpocket.
Pickpocket.
Match. And win. Now it's time for the huge big money super match. This is where you can win over $10,000, but you already know that. You've been here a couple times, right? Haven't you? All right, now to start, you know how this works. We start with an audience match. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, we polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Blank opera. Now, if you can guess the most popular answer, you will get $500. If you guess the second most popular, it'd be $250. Or the third best answer, you get $100. Now, you can get some help from the celebrities here. Enlist three of them if you'd like to help you fill in the blank there. Who would you like to pick?
Start off with Deborah. She got me here.
Oh, Jeff, Deborah. Thank you. I would say light opera.
Light opera. Joe?
How about a night at the opera?
Light opera, I find half the calories. I would say soap opera.
Soap opera. Oh. Alright, so you have soap opera, light opera, and comedy opera. Or you can pick one of your own.
I think I'd have to go with soap opera.
You're gonna go with soap opera. Okay. Alright, let's see how we did. Let's take a look at the $100 answer, please. Grand Ole Opera. Nobody had that one. The $250 answer was soap opera. There you have it. Let's take a look at the $500 answer. Phantom of the Opera. All right, you have $250, which means you'll be playing for at least 10 times that, or $2,500 by playing one of our celebrities head to head. Double that amount if you can get a lucky spin on our star wheel. Oh, hey, look at that. Why don't you take your position up there, and I'll explain this. A lot of times, Jeff, as you know, you're going to give the star wheel a spin.
It was hardly noticeable.
It was, wasn't it?
You can cover it with a line, Moss.
It's like his first day on the job, isn't it, up there? You spin this, whichever star it lands on will be your partner in the head-to-head. If it does land on one of these red dots, it'll be double the money, or $5,000. All right, now see if you can spin it without throwing it off its axis. That star wheel took a nice bounce, didn't it, to that star wheel. Well, obviously, Charles is your partner. Did land on a W for playing for $5,000, but you have to match him head to head, and we're looking for an exact match. All right, now we need no audience help here at all. We don't want to be distracting. Answer this, Jeff. Book blank. Charles, write down your answer to book blank.
I'll do it soon.
Okay, it looks like Charles has got his answer.
Well, I mean, you know what I mean.
Okay, Jeff. What is your answer, Jeff, to book blank?
Bookshelf.
Bookshelf. Book cover. Oh, it wasn't. It wasn't that.
We had bookmark, bookworm. We had a meeting. Book. We didn't think of shelf.
Joe had Bookum Dano.
Bookum Dano. Bookum Mark Club. There were a lot of different answers. Well, you didn't get that one. But you're coming back as our champion tomorrow. We'll be right back after this break. Talk about that. Well, we're just about out of time. But Jeff has collected $24,800 and comes back tomorrow as our returning champion. So it wasn't an awful day at all.
Not a good day at all.
No. Well, we're going to take off now, but we will see you next time on Match Game, folks. Bye-bye.
Departing contestants will receive the revolutionary conical contact camera, one of the world's first voice-activated cameras, automatically takes pictures in response to sound from Tonica. Resintel's Escapade Luggage Collection, an inexpensive escape from traditional luggage. Single shell molding, rugged construction, with every design from Resintel. Archway, ginger snaps, and oatmeal cookies. Low in sodium, low cholesterol, and no palm oil. The good food cookies, always fresh in your store. This is Gene Woods speaking for Match Game. A Mark Goodson television production. Get ready to match the star. The star of Twisted Challenge, Jonathan Frint. From the Golden Girls, Betty White. Match Game's own, Charles Nelson Riley. From Mama's Family, Vicki Lawrence. From Out of This World, Joe Lasky. And from just the 10 of us, Deborah Harmon, as we play the all-new star-studded Match Game. And here's the star of Match Game, Ross Schaefer.
An extra howl. We got an extra howl from the audience. Hello, stars.
Hi.
It's good to see you. Now, those of you who have watched Match Game, you know that Joe does impressions.
Oh, he's wonderful.
He's wonderful, does an impression. I want you to do this, because this is an impression you don't normally hear. It's not a famous person that's flesh and blood. It's a cartoon. Now, it's Barney Rubble. Do Barney.
Hey, Fred, we gonna, go down to the Bedrock Bowl tonight?
It's
a moving.
It's a letter. You don't look that much like him either.
Well, thanks.
All right, let's say hello to the contestants here. Hi, Jeff. Jeff, you've done very well in the game. You have $24,800 so far. You're back in as the champion. Sandy, now this is our new competitor. Sandy, tell us about yourself.
My name is Sandy Castle, and I live in Ventura, California, and I work as a waitress up there.
You do? You work? what kind of waitress? What kind of restaurant is
family
it?
Family restaurant, family.
That's very vague. You're being very vague with what you're trying to say. All right. You want to play a match game?
Yes.
Okay.
Ross, are you sure that's not Tracy Ullman?
I'm not sure. It could be Tracy Ullman. Let's play. You know how we do this. The goal is to match as many of our celebrities as you can. Every correct match is worth $50. At the end of the game, the person who scores the most is the winner, keeps the money, and gets to play our super match for a shot at $10,000. Jeff, you're the big guy. You're the flyboy. You're the champion so far. Question A or B?
Well, let's go with A this time.
Okay. Going with A. Okay. Stars, Zsa Zsa said.
Uh-oh.
Oh, sure.
No. Kick them when they're down, huh?
Zsa Zsa who?
Zsa Zsa who? Zsa Zsa said, darling, my sister Ava always copies me, but she's such a wimp. Instead of slapping a cop, she slapped a blank. Zsa Zsa said, my sister Ava is such a wimp. Instead of slapping a cop, she slapped a blank.
Oh,
how are you doing,
awful.
Jonathan?
I don't know. I'm done. But...
you have another category.
We'll go with C.
I got
well, I'm getting trouble.
Are you?
Let me get to the first one.
You get in trouble with Zsa Zsa, Charles?
Okay, I got it.
Okay, all of a sudden, sorry, Jeff. Zsa Zsa says that Ava's a wimp. Instead of slapping a cop, Ava slapped a...
right hook to the meter maid.
Meter maid. Okay, well, we'll see if we get that. A meter maid. Instead of slapping a cop, Ava slapped a...
That's a good answer. I thought she was such a wimp, she slapped a baby's behind. Start again.
All right, Betty.
What do you got better, Betty?
I thought mine was the worst answer of this entire panel. I feel much better now. Thank you, Jonathan. Mine is the second worst. Street cleaner.
A street cleaner. No match. Now, Charles.
When you're right.
Charles, you thought you'd get
that
in trouble.
That woman hasn't seen garbage since 1941. Okay, what?
What? Yes, this meter maid is what we're looking for.
Boy Scout.
Boy Scout. Pretty good answer, yeah. That's pretty good. No match yet. No match, Vicky. Zsa Zsa. She didn't slap a cop. She slapped a...
That was a good answer. I said she slapped a kid.
A kid.
Ooh, ouch.
Vicky Joe.
Well, can I do another cop impression? Here's Gunther Tutti from Car 54.
Ooh, meter maid.
Deborah,
I just hate being last. I feel like Sandy. I just feel like this. It's like a meter maid.
All right, great. We got a couple of matches for you. All right, now, Sandy, your first shot at this game. Sheldon the shoplifter had a rough time at the pet store. This is Sheldon the shoplifter.
Yeah. I know him well.
Know what he did?
What?
Tried to stuff a blank down his pants. Sheldon the shoplifter had a very rough time at the pet store.
Mama?
No.
He tried to stuff a blank down his pants.
I can't say my answer. Will you say my answer?
You can't say it. You can write it, but you can't say your answer.
Vicky, will you say my answer for me?
Oh, she's done?
Oh, yes.
Jonathan, are you done?
Oh, I was born done.
You were born? Oh, put your light on. There we go. Okay. Deborah? Deborah's in, too?
Oh, yeah,
good.
In.
Okay. Sandy, are you ready for this one? Sheldon the shoplifter had a bad time at the pet store. He tried to stuff a... what down his pants?
A gerbil.
I didn't hear that.
You know, that's not the answer I would have picked.
Are you okay?
Jonathan,
Wow! Can you say that on TV, Sandy? That's not the answer I had, Russ.
Good.
Yeah, good. Sheldon the shoplifter had a tough time. He tried to stuff a pit bull down his pants.
A pit bull down his pants. Sheldon tried to stuff a what, Betty, down his pants?
Animal lover that I am. He was just putting a bite on a friend. I think a boa.
A boa. A boa, yeah. Charles, we're looking for...
I have a very
gerbil.
Odd pet store in my area. Porcupine.
Vicky, help us out. The shoplifter had a bad time. He tried to stuff a what?
I, Betty, and I thought alike.
A boa.
Thank you, sweetheart.
Still no matches, Joe.
No matches, sorry.
A
snake.
Sorry. All right, Deborah?
I was along the same line. I was just a little bit more alliterative. I had a python down his pants.
A python. No. We did not find a gerbil in the bunch. We're going to take a little break, a well-deserved break. We'll come back to play matchup. We'll build up your score by playing against the clock in a minute. Please stay around. first round, Jeff has 100. Sandy, you don't have anything yet, but don't worry, it's early in the game, and now it's time for us to play matchup. This is where you can build up your score by playing against the clock, and since, Sandy, you're behind, we'll start with you. You can play with any one of our stars. Who would you like to play with?
Play with Vicky.
I'm going to go with Vicky Lawrence. Okay, what we'll do is show you a series of possible matchups. Use the button on your secret screen there to select the answer that you feel is best, and every time that Vicky agrees with you, you'll get $50. We'll put 30 seconds on the clock to get as many as you can. Vicky, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Sandy's ready?
Yeah.
Go. Slam blank. Slam the door, slam dunk.
Slam dunk.
Match. Petty blank. Petty theft, petty cash.
Petty cash.
No match. Check blank. Checkbook, checkmate.
Checkbook.
Match. Aqua blank. Aqua lung, aqua velva.
Aqua lung.
No match. TV blank. TV dinner, TV guide.
TV guide.
No match. Ice blank. Ice water, ice chest.
Ice water.
No match.
Ooh. Who's the end?
Tied the score, though. Got a couple of matches. Jeff, your turn. Who do you want to play with?
Let's go with Joe.
Joe Alasky. All right.
Must be that meter maid.
$50 now for every match. Get as many as you can in the 30 seconds. Joe's ready?
Ready.
Jeff's ready? Go. King blank. King Midas, King Kong.
King Midas.
Match. Lady blank. Lady bug, lady finger.
Lady bug.
Match. Mark blank. Mark Harmon, Mark Goodson.
Mark Harmon.
Match. Water blank. Watergate, watermelon.
Watermelon.
Match. Hot blank. Hot tamale, hot potato.
Hot tamale.
No match. Ronald blank. Ronald Reagan, Ronald McDonald.
Ronald Reagan.
Match. Joy blank. Oh. Nice job. Jeff has 350. Sandy has 100. We'll take a little break. We'll come back with more Match Game in just a minute. Sandy, you have 100. So, Sandy, you can make a selection. Question here.
B.
You'll go with B. Okay. Ooh, the bank manager said to Sally the stripper. I don't know why she's in a bank, but this is... The bank manager said to her, I can give you the loan, but I'll have to hold your blanks as collateral. The bank manager said to Sally the stripper, I can give you a loan, but I'll have to hold your blanks as collateral.
I don't know how to spell it.
Everybody in? Okay. Sandy? I would avoid rodent answers in this one. The bank manager said to Sally the stripper, I can give you the loan, but I'll have to hold your blanks as collateral.
Tassels?
Tassels. Very good. Very good. The bank guy said, I'll have to hold your...
I went right for the real thing there, Sandy. I went breasts.
Breasts.
I'm sorry, I'm out of tassel name.
Oh, Betty.
Well, I don't even understand the question.
Things, but I think this is a match. Tassel sounds like it's a parade question. I said pasties.
It's not the same?
Sure they
are. We'll have to take that one up with the judge.
Boy, they turned.
Yeah. All right. The Sally the stripper's trying to get a loan, and the bank guy says, I'll give you the loan, but I have to hold your...
Here she is. Tassels.
Tassels for collateral.
Hey, Abbott! I'm afraid I picked the pasties.
The pasties. Nope. Deborah, we're looking for tassels.
Mine's a little different. Assets.
Yeah. Assets. No. All right. Sandy, you have 200. You have 350. Jeff, we have another question here.
It's a pun.
Tammy Faye Baker said... Tammy Faye said, I lost over 10 pounds last week. It was so easy, I just took off my blanks.
What?
I just took off my blank.
Blank.
Singular.
Blank.
Blank. Singular.
Blank. Singular?
Yeah,
singular.
I just took off my blank.
Oh, it's one?
One. A single blank.
Blank.
Was that a good one, Joe?
That was a good one.
Okay, Betty, Charles are in.
Yo!
Okay, Jeff.
I'm in.
I lost over 10 pounds last week, Tammy Faye said. I just took off my...
Gotta be makeup.
Makeup. Okay. just took off my...
I was going to say gerbil, and then I was going to say pasty, but I said makeup.
Makeup. There's a match.
This may be a match, and then again it may not be. I thought blank, you could fill in whatever word you wanted in the blank, whether singular or plural or anything. I said lashes. That's part of makeup.
That's part, but not a match. No, they're saying not a match. Charles?
Chuck said the correct answer.
Yeah, I'm here to go. Vicky?
Yes, sir.
She just took off her.
I'm with Jeff. It's got to be makeup.
Makeup, yes.
Back to Lou Costello again, or was it the Three Stooges? Makeup!
Good. Yeah, do we have another makeup? Yes, we have another makeup. Five matches, Jeff. You're in a good spot now. You have 600. Sandy has 200. But now it is time for final matchup. Whoever wins this round wins the game and a chance to play for a possible $10,000. Sandy, you're trailing, so you'll get to go first. Who would you like to play with?
Jonathan.
I'm going to play with Jonathan. All right. Now, this time, instead of the $50 for every matchup, it's worth $100.
Wow.
We're going to give you 45 seconds instead of 30 to get as many as you can. All right. You have 200. Go as far as you can, but you must get at least 600 to stay in the game. Okay, we'll put 45 seconds on the clock. Sandy, you ready?
Yes.
Jonathan's ready? Go. Blank, clean. Squeaky clean, Mr. Clean.
Squeaky clean.
No match. Blank, worm. Earthworm, bookworm.
Earthworm.
No match. Blank, Tracy. Spencer Tracy, Dick Tracy.
Dick Tracy.
No match. Blank, trap. Sand trap, mouse trap.
Mouse trap.
Match. Blank, test. IQ test, driving test.
IQ test.
Match. Blank food. Chinese food, dog food.
Chinese food.
No match. Blank duck. Daffy duck, Donald duck.
Donald duck.
Match. Blank beer. Light beer, root beer.
Light beer.
No match. Blank stick. Swizzle stick, hockey stick.
Swizzle stick.
Oh, we're out of time. We have a winner, Jeff. Jeff, come on over. Without having to go into the final matchup. Sandy, thank you very much for playing. Please say hello to people in the restaurant for us, will you? We have some nice things for you backstage. Okay, we're going to take a break. We'll be right back with our big money super match. And Jeff's getting pretty good at this, so stay tuned. This is the big money, the super match, and you can win over $10,000. This is your fifth time you've been in this position.
That's right.
Oh, you're getting to be an old hat at this. We ought to charge you a rent, I think. We'll start with an audience match. You know how this works.
Mm-hmm.
We polled a recent audience and got their best response to this. Holy blank. Now, if you can guess the most popular answer, you'll get $500. Second most popular answer is $250. And if you guess the third most popular answer, it's $100. Now, you can ask any three celebrities to help you. Which ones would you like to ask?
Well, start off with Joe.
Okay, Joe.
Holy cow.
Holy cow. Holy cow.
Okay, let's keep Deborah in the seat. Deborah
just wants to play so badly.
Holy Bible.
Holy Bible. One more.
Vicky, you had the winner last time.
Holy moly.
Holy moly?
Yeah.
Holy moly. Yeah. All right, now, you can choose one of your answers or go with one of your answers.
I probably want to go with mine, Jeff.
Let's go with the Holy Bible.
You're going to go with Holy Bible. Okay. Yeah. Good. All right. Let's take a look and see how well you have done. Let's see what the $100 answer is. Holy Roller. Holy Nobody roller. Had that one.
Okay.
Nobody guessed Got Holy it. Roller. All right. For $250, Holy Bible.
Got
Holy
it.
Bible. That's what you had. Deborah, see, you wanted to play. All right, out of curiosity, let's take a look at the $500 answer.
Holy cow.
There it is.
Holy
All right.
Holy, wow.
But you have $250, which means you'll be playing for at least 10 times that, or $2,500 by matching one of our celebrities head-to-head. You could be playing for double that amount if we get a lucky spin on our star wheel. So let's bring it in.
That's funny.
Yeah, we're all standing back. Yesterday, it just about hurt you, didn't it? All right, go ahead and get up there. You're going to give this a spin, Jeff. If it lands on one of these stars, that's who you'll play with in the head-to-head. If it lands on one of these red dots, you'll be worth double or $5,000. So give it a good spin.
Here we go.
The double, but Deborah is your partner in the head-to-head.
Oh, no.
Okay, babe.
Face me.
Thank you.
Now, we're playing for $2,500. Got to match your head-to-head. It's got to be an exact match this time. And please, we need no help from the audience on this one. Ready for this? Think of this one, Jeff. Cry blank. Cry blank. Deborah, write your answer down. Okay, I think she's checking to make sure.
Yeah.
She's got that one? All right, Jeff, why don't you turn around here. What is your answer for cry blank?
Well, I got a little boy coming in about 3 months, and it's a baby.
So you're going to say cry baby.
Baby.
Cry baby. Congratulations, right back to your phone. We'll come back and tell you how much he's won in a moment. Please, stay with us. Well, thank you very much for joining us. Jeff has been with us 5 times. He leaves us with $27,900. And get this, look at this. He won. They're having a new baby. They win on baby, and Deborah was hoping that they would connect on that.
That's right.
Yeah. So what will you buy for the baby?
Well, the wife has already got out. We've got a crib, the changing table, the dresser. She's on a roll.
That's right. All right. We have to take off, but we'll see you next time on Match Game. Thanks, folks.
Departing contestants will receive your choice of his or hers. Jules Jurgensen diamond dial watches, elegantly styled. His with 20 genuine diamonds. Hers with 10. The classic series by Jules Jurgensen. Klondike light bars. A delicious frozen dessert with only 110 calories per bar. A tasty treat from Klondike. Dum Dum Pops, the favorite leader in lollipops with 14 flavors. Dum Dum, one of America's favorites for generations. Speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson Television production.
I'm the master reptile.